guys, today I'm doing a requested video that was requested months ago. I'm horrible at getting back to requests, so if any of you have any spring makeup tutorials you would like to request for me now, that would be great, because then I'll get them up by spring. No, but really, today I'm doing a Battle of the Brands, which I used to do these not really that often. I have a couple of them on my channel, where I take two different products, usually one high-end and one drugstore, and then compare them to see which one is better, and if you can save money and get the low-cost alternative, or if it's worth the splurge to get the high-end one. Now, this particular Battle of the Brands is on corrective under-eye concealer, corrector things. First one is the NYX Dark Circle Concealer, and this is the Bobbi Brown Corrector. I'm going to be talking about these, prices and stuff, so let's just jump into this Battle of the Brands. First off, we have the NYX Dark Circle Concealer. I actually didn't look up the prices of either of these before I started filming, which was kind of stupid on my part, but this is about $6 or $7. You can get it at Ulta, wherever NYX is sold. Presumably the website you can probably buy it. Now, what a corrector is for your under eye areas, it's something that's usually a little bit yellow toned or a little bit peach toned that helps to cancel out the bluish purpley under eye circles that we all get when we don't have sleep or when we don't have sleep. Yeah, this is what a corrector looks like. It's kind of a skin tone concealer, but a little bit of a peachy tone. Now, what it's supposed to do is supposed to help, like I said, correct your under eye areas. You just apply it with your finger under your eyes. You could use a brush. I find that it's best to apply correctors with your finger, because then it, like, the heat of your hand kind of helps to blend it in better. So this is the NYX one. I have the shade Fair, and this has 0.1 ounce, 2.9 grams. This Bobbi Brown one, I'm in the shade Light Bisque. This has 0.05 ounces, or 1.4 grams. So you get more in the NYX one already. Now, packaging-wise, they both have like a black lid with the white writing. The NYX one comes in kind of a clear jar. It's plastic, and the Bobbi Brown one, it's like super fancy looking. There's like a mirror with it, and it just comes in a little pan like that. Now, consistency wise, the NYX one, these are both very smooth. I'm kind of like touching it now. It's very smooth. It blends really nicely. It just blends nicely into the skin, and it's not like too dry. That's my biggest issue with some under eye concealers, is that if they dry and kind of cake up, neither of these do that, which is super nice. I don't find that either of these concealers crease. I don't really have an issue with concealers creasing on me personally. If you do, I would recommend putting a little bit of a face primer underneath where you put your concealer, and that'll prevent the concealer from creasing. As for the Bobbi Brown one, this is also very smooth and creamy, but I find that it's a little bit thicker in consistency, giving it a hint more coverage than the NYX one. When you blend it in, it's a little bit thicker. They're both very creamy, like I said, but the Bobbi Brown one's a little bit thicker in consistency of the NYX one. Honestly, I would say that these two products are pretty similar to one another. The biggest difference is that the Bobbi Brown one is a little bit thicker. I find that if I apply too much of this one, there's a bigger chance that it will crease, but that's pretty much for any concealer, honestly. But this one, I would say it gives like a hint more coverage than the NYX one, but the NYX one still does cover up my under eye circles. Now, I have really bad dark circles, so like I have to use something that is peach toned, or else it won't, like just regular concealer wouldn't do anything. I find that the NYX one and the Bobbi Brown one both correct my dark circles very nicely. The biggest issue is this one is $20-something, and between $22 and $26, I'm not totally sure. I will have both of these products linked down below. I will link this one through the Sephora website and this one through the Ulta website. The NYX one is about $6, $5, $6. So definitely, if you get the NYX one, you're definitely saving money. Honestly, between the two, if I were to use up both right now and I would need to go out and buy another one, I would definitely pick up the NYX one. It's cheaper, it's just as good, it's not as thick, so there's a lesser chance that it'll like cake up, and you get a lot more product in this one than you do with this one. Shade selection, I would say that the Bobbi Brown one has a bigger shade selection than the NYX. The NYX does have a smaller shade selection, as do most drugstore concealers compared to higher end concealers, but I'm sure you could definitely find a shade that would work for you. So that is my Battle of the Brands review on the Bobbi Brown Corrector versus the NYX Dark Circle Concealer. I hope this was helpful. I don't really know if it was or not. Definitely, if you have any questions about these products or if there's anything I didn't cover that you wanted to know, definitely leave it in a comment down below and I will be sure to get back to you. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this battle of the brands, and if you have any video requests, as always, let me know down below, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!